Archiving your records in Airtable is easy, but works a little differently than in most other products. You can apply filters to your views to archive projects that aren't relevant anymore. This allows you to focus on what you still need to get done, while also keeping record of the things you've already completed. With filters, you get to define what you see and when you see it. For example, let's say you're using Airtable as a digital content calendar. In this view, we can see all of your website's content, regardless of whether or not it's already been published. But it would be great to have one view that only showed upcoming articles and another that acted as an archive for already published articles. We can set this up by creating a new view that will function as our archive. Let's call it Archive of Published Articles. Next, I'll create a filter where the publication date is before today. Now, all published articles will automatically show up in this view. Then, I can create another grid view and call it Articles in Production. Let's establish a new filter where the publication date is after today. Now, this view will only show upcoming articles, and any articles that eventually become published will automatically appear in the archive. And if I'd prefer not to archive articles immediately after they're published, that's fine too. I can easily adjust the filters so that records move to the archive view a certain amount of time after they're published. And remember, you haven't permanently moved or deleted any of your archived records. You've just filtered them out of, or into, certain views. This process is applicable to a number of different workflows beyond a digital content calendar, and you can use it with any field that denotes a completion date or status to ensure that finished projects are always automatically moved to your archive view. For example, the same process can be applied to records via a single select or checkbox field, too. Now that you're familiar with Airtable's unique way of archiving, go ahead and give it a try on your own. If you run into any trouble, remember, you can always check out our support pages, community forum, or simply drop us a line. See you next time!